Where are you going? Morning bell ain't rung yet. Get back to sleep.
I want to beat the other fellas to the street. I don't want anyone to see. I ain't been walking so good.
Quit griping. You know how many fellas fake a limb for sympathy? That bum leg of yours is a gold mine.
Gee, if someone gets the idea I can't make on my own, they'll lock me up in the refuge for good. Now be a pal, Jack, and help me down.
You want to bust the other leg too?
No! I want to go down!
You'll be down soon enough. Take a moment. Drink in my penthouse high above the stinking streets of New York.
You're crazy.
Because I like a breath of fresh air? Because I like seeing the sky and the stars?
You're seeing stars, all right.
Them streets down there suck the life right out of my old man. Years of rotten jobs stomped on by bosses. When they finally broke him, they kicked him to the curb like yesterday's paper. Well, they ain't doing that to me.
But everyone wants to come here.
New York's fine for those who can afford a big, strong door to lock it out. But there's a whole other way out there, Crutchy. So you keep your small life in a big city. Give me a big life in a small town.
They say folks is dying to get here. Me, I'm dying to get away.
To a little town out west that's spanking new.
And while I ain't never been there, I can see it clear as day.
If you want, I bet you you could see it too.
Close your eyes, come with me, where it's clean and green and pretty. And they went and made a city out of clay. Why, the minute that you get there, folks will walk right up and say, welcome home, son. Welcome home to Santa Fe. Planting crops, splitting rails, swapping tails around the fire, except for Sunday when you lie around all day. Soon your friends is more like family, and they's begging you to stay. Ain't that neat? Living sweet in Santa Fe.
You got folks there?
Don't got folks nowhere. You?
I don't need folks. I got friends.
Well, how's about you come with me? Don't no one care about no bum leg in Santa Fe. You just hop a palomino and you ride in style.
Yeah, picture me riding in style.
Hey, I bet a few months of fresh air, you could toss that crutch for good.
Them bastards beat us. We won't beg no one to treat us fair and square. There's a life that's worth the living, and I'm gonna do my share.
Work the land, chase the sun,
swim the whole Rio Grande just for fun.
Watch me stand, watch me run.
Hey, don't you know that we's a family? Would I let you down? No way. Just hang on, kid, till that train makes Santa Fe. Time for dreaming's done. Hey, Specs, race to Henry, Albert, Alma! Get a move on, boys, and pets don't sell them.
Having the most beautiful dream. My lips is still tingling.
A pretty goyle?
A leg of lamb.
Huh? Hey, that's my cigar.
You'll steal another.
Hey, look, it's bath time at the zoo.
I thought that I'd surprise my mother.
If you can find her.
Who asked you?
My papes ain't been selling like they used to. I need a new selling spot. You got any ideas?
From Bottle Alley to the harbor, there's easy pickings guaranteed. Try any banker, bum, or barber. They almost all knows how to read.
It's a crooked game we're playing. One will never lose. Long as suckers don't mind paying just to get bad news.
Ain't it a fine life? Mary and the banner through it all. A mighty fine life, Carrie and the banner tough and tall. When that bell rings, we go where we wish it. We the three officials, sure beats washing dishes. But a fine life, Carrie and the banner home free all.
Well, hello, hello, beautiful.
Step aside, Romeo. Nothing what concerns you here. Good morning, miss. Could I interest you in the latest news?
The paper isn't out yet.
Well, I'd be delighted to deliver it.
Personally.
I've got a headline for you. Cheeky boy gets nothing for his troubles.
Back to the bench. You struck out, slugger.
I'm crushed.
Hey, Crutchy, what's your leg say? Gonna rain?
No rain. Partly cloudy, clear by evening.
We gotta bottle this guy.
And the limp sells 50 papes a week, all by itself.
I don't need the limp to sell papes. I got poisonality. Oh. It takes a smile that spreads like butter, the kind that toins a lady's head.
It takes an orphan with a stutter,
who's also blind
and mute and dead.
Summer stinks and winter's freezing. You works outdoors, start up sweating, end up sneezing, in between it pours. There is a fine life, carrying the banner with the bomb, carrying the banner with the big shots, tossing out a freebie, just a big shot, tossing out a freebie.
The hold up, waiting makes me antsy, I like living chancy.
All into the lazy, what a
grub, sister.
Elmer, when am I gonna see Hugh inside the church?
I don't know, sister, but it's bound to rain sooner or later.
Curdle.
Just give me half a cup.
Coffee.
Something to wake me up.
Concrete.
I gotta find an angle.
Is it two for a penny? If I take too many, weasel just makes me eat a mantha.
Got a feeling about a headline. Eyes go see a headline change. They're gonna sell like we was giving them away. Bet your dinner is a doozy. Kiss your pet, your loozy. How to make the news these days. Wanna move on an exposition. Give up your headline for a war.
How about a crooked politician?
You live with.
No!
Not again.
3 weeks of the same story.
You're killing us with that snoozer.
Make way, step aside.
Dear me, what is that unpleasant aroma? I fear Jasua may have backed up during the night.
Or could it be
the Delancey brothers?
Hey, Oscar, word on the street says you and your brother took money to beat up striking trolley workers.
So, it's honest work.
You're cracking the head of defenseless workers?
I take care of the guy who takes care of me.
Ain't your father one of the workers?
Yes, he didn't take care of me.
What did you love to crank?
Now that's not nice, Morris.
I'll fight the one Jack skunks him.
Yeah. Now, one unfortunate day, you might find you got a bum game of your own. How'd you like us picking on you? Or maybe we should find out.
Oh! Wait till I get my hands on you!
You gotta catch me first!
We'll all be out there.
Did you miss me?
The name's Wiesel.
Ain't that what I said?
Yeah.
I'll take the usual.
100 papes for the wise guy.
How's it going, Weasel?
The police call me mister.
I'll call you sweetheart if you'd spot me 50 papes.
Drop the cash and move along.
Whatever happened to romance?
50 papes for the race. Next.
Good morning, Mr. Wiesel.
50 papes for crutchy. Have a look at the new kid.
I'm new too.
Don't worry, kid. Rubs right off.
I'll take 20 newspapers, please.
20 papes for the new kid. Let's see the dime.
I'll pay you when I sell them.
Funny, kid. Come on, cash up front.
But whatever I don't sell, you buy back, right?
Certainly. Plus, every time you lose a tooth, I'll put a penny under your pillow. This kid is a riot. Now, come on, cough up the cash or blow. Move along. Ah, Albert, let me see your money.
You have a very interesting face. You ever think about getting in the moving pictures?
You think I could?
Oh, well, sure. Buy a ticket. They let anyone in.
Sorry, excuse me, but I paid for 20 newspapers and you only gave me 19.
You see how nice I was to the new kid. And what do I get for my civility? Ungrounded accusation.
I just want what I paid
for. He said beat it.
New kid's right, Weasel. You gave him 19. I'm sure it's an honest mistake on account of Oscar can't count the 20 with his shoes on.
Yeah. Now take a hike.
Give him another 50 papes.
I don't want more papes.
What kind of news you don't want more papes?
I'm no charity case. I don't even know you.
His name's Jack.
This here is the famous Jack Kelly. He once escaped jail on the back of Teddy Roosevelt's carriage. Made all the papes.
How old are you, kid?
I'm 12. Almost.
Well, if anyone asks, you're 9. Younger sells more papes than if we're going to be partners.
Hey, who says we want to be partners?
Selling with Jack is the chance of a lifetime. You'll learn from him, you'll learn from the best.
Well, if he's the best, then what's he need with me?
Because you got a little sister and I don't. That face could easy sell 1,000 papes a week. Look sad, kid.
We're gonna make millions!
This is my brother David. I'm Les.
Nice to meet you, Davy. My 2 bits come off the top, we split everything else 70-30.
50-50. You wouldn't try to pull a fast one on a little kid.
60-40. And that's my final offer.
Deal.
That's disgusting.
That's just business. Newsies, hit the streets! The sun is up, the headline stinks, and this kid ain't getting any younger.
We'll be out there.
Out there, soaking every second that we can. It's a headline, newsy mom mission. circulation is down for the third quarter in a row.
But, Mr. Pulitzer, every paper's circulation is down since the war has ended.
Whoever said war is hell wasn't trying to sell newspapers.
Well, we could always use an exciting headline.
What have we got today?
The trolley strike.
That's not exciting. It's epic.
It's boring. Folks want to know, is the trolley coming or ain't it? No one cares why.
And the strike's about to be settled. Governor Roosevelt has just put his support behind the workers.
That man is a socialist!
Teddy Roosevelt is no socialist. He's an American hero.
The man wants to outlaw football for being too violent. Football? Violent? You're right. He's no socialist. He's a commie.
Mr. Pulitzer believes you must try to sit still.
Gentlemen, you are making Nunzio nervous. And when Nunzio gets nervous, I don't look pretty.
You never liked Roosevelt. You wrote an editorial against him day after day when he ran for governor. And guess what? He got elected.
How can I influence voters when they're not reading my opinion?
Now, big photos attract readers.
Do you know what big photos cost?
But without flashy photos or headlines, how are we supposed to sell more papers?
There's an answer right before your eyes. You're just not thinking this through. People, Nunzio knows when he's cutting my hair. Trim a bit here, and then trim a bit there. Just a modest adjustment can fatten the bottom line.
Mr. Pulitzer believes.
Shaving is tricky, the razor should float. Shave me too close, and you may cut my throat. It's the simplest solutions that bolster the bottom line.
But I still don't understand how that helps us sell papers.
We don't sell papers, silly. Nosies sell papers.
I've got it. Right now, we charge the newsies 50 cents per hundred for paper.
Yes?
But if we were to raise their price to, say, 60 cents per hundred...
Now you're getting somewhere.
You're a tenth of a penny per paper.
Every single newsie would have to sell 25 more papers just to make the same amount as always.
My thought exactly. It's genius.
Well, that's going to be awfully rough on those children.
Nonsense. I'll be giving them a real-life lesson in economics. Why, I couldn't offer them a better education if they were my own. Give me a week and I'll train them to be like an army that's marching to war. Proud of themselves and so grateful to me, they'll be begging to pay even more. When there's dirt on our shoes, boys, for God's sake, relax. Why throw them out? All we need is some wax. Listen well to these barbershop lessons, for they'll see you through.
When you're stuck in the muck, you'll be fine. You'll erase any trace of decline.
With a trim
and a snip
and a shine
and the power of the press, yes, once again is mine. The price for the newsies goes up in the morning. Just a few common sense checks. That's the bottom line.
Sun up to sun down, knowing where my customers will be. Sun up to sun down, watching all the ladies watching me. Put my shoes.
Why don't you? Let me see that. Extra, extra, terrified flight from Burning Inferno. You heard the story right here. Thanks, mister.
You just made that up.
Did not. I said he heard the story right here, and he did.
Well, my father taught us not to lie.
Mine taught me not to starve.
Hey, just sold my last paper.
I got one more.
Sell it or pay for it.
Give it here. Buy a paper from a poor orphan girl.
Oh, you dear thing. Of course I'll take a newspaper. Oh. Here's a dime.
Born to the breed.
This is so much better than school!
Don't even think it. When Pop goes back to work, we go back to school.
Let's say we divvy up the money, grab us some chow, and find you somewhere safe to spend the night.
Yeah, we'd love to, but we better be getting home. Our folks are probably waiting on dinner.
Oh, you got folks.
Doesn't everyone?
Our dad tangled with the delivery truck on the job and messed up his leg pretty bad. So they laid him off. That's how come we had to find work.
Yeah, sure, makes sense. Too bad about your dad.
You know what, why don't you come home for dinner? I'm sure our folks will be happy to have you.
Mom's a great cook.
Thanks for the invite, but I just remembered I got plans with a fella. He's probably waiting for me right now.
Is that the guy you're meeting?
Jack Kelly!
Run for
Officer, stop it! Stop! Kelly! Stop! Jack Kelly!
Slow down. We lost him.
Someone want to tell me why I'm running? I got nobody chasing me. Who was that guy?
That was Snyder the Spider. A real sweetheart. He runs a jail for underage kids called The Refuge. The more kids he brings in, the more money the city gives him. Trouble is, all that money goes straight into his own pocket. Do yourselves a favor. Steer clear of him and The Refuge.
Shoo up there! No kids allowed in the theater!
Not even me, Miss Meta?
Ooh, Jack Kelly! Man of mystery! Get yourself down here and give me a hug! Where have you been keeping yourself, kid?
Never far from you, Meta.
Oh.
Les, Davey, may I present Miss Meta Larkin, the best talent on the Bowery today. And she owns the joint.
Only thing I own is the mortgage. Pleasure.
It's a pleasure. Hey, what's the matter with you?
Are you blind? They got no clothes on.
That's her costume.
But I can see her legs.
Listen.
Oh, step out of her way so she can get a better look. The theater's not only entertaining, it's educational, too. Got the picture, kid?
Miss Meta, I got a little situation outside. Mind if I hide out here a while?
Where better to escape trouble than a theater? It's Snyder after you again.
Hey, Jack, did you really escape jail on the back of Teddy Roosevelt's carriage?
Now, come on. What would the governor be doing at a juvenile jail?
So happens he was running for office and wanted to show he cared about orphans and such. So while he got his mug in the paper, I hopped my butt in the back seat and we rode off together.
You really know the governor?
He don't, but I do. Say, Jack, when you got some time, I want you to paint me some more of those backdrops. That first one you did is a doozy. Folks love it. And things have been going so well, I can actually pay.
I could never take your money, Miss Meta.
You picture that?
Your friend is quite an artist.
Don't get excited. It's a bunch of trees.
But you're really good.
This boy has natural aptitude.
Jeez. I never knew no one with an aptitude.
Miss Meta, you're on?
Yeah. How am I doing? Woo, lock the door and stay all night. You're with Meta now.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the star of our show, Miss Meta Larkin.
Myself, folks. I'm healthy, I'm wealthy, I'm wise. My investments and such have all gone up so much, seems whatever I touch starts to rise. I've been all kinds of lucky, and yet the thing I want most, I can't get. Well, hello again. So good to see you. Oh, hello. hello, ladies. I live in a mansion on Long Island Sound. I pulled up a weed, they found oil in the ground. But are you telling me you don't want me around? Now, honey, that's rich. Some guys give me ermine, chinchilla, and mink. And some give me diamonds as big as a sink. But you wouldn't give me as much as a wing. Now, baby, that's rich. I get brandy from Andy and candy from Scott. Oh, and Frank and Eduardo, chicken for the yacht. I get dirt from the fellas, bread from the poop. But I ran out my luck getting stuck with this mope. Oh, hey, honey, I was just talking about you. Listen, sport, this life's too short to waste it on you. It may be rough, but soon enough, I learned to make do with the mansion, the oil well, the diamonds, the yacht, with Andy Eduardo, the pontiff, and Scott, and Frank, oh, and my bank. So still no cheese.
I should lock the door twice in one day. Think it's fate?
Go away! I'm working.
A working girl, huh? Doing what?
Reviewing the show for the New York Sun.
Well, hey, I work for the world.
Oh, somewhere out there, someone cares. Go tell them.
The view's better here.
Please go. I'm not in the habit of speaking to strangers.
Then you're gonna make one lousy reporter. Name's Jack Kelly.
Is that what it says on your rap sheet?
Oh, a smart girl, huh? I admire smart girls. Beautiful, smart, independent.
Do you mind?
You got in for free. At least pay attention.
Sorry, Meta. I got no use for moonlight or sappy poetry. Love at first sight's for suckers, at least it used to be. Look, girls are nice, once or twice, till I find someone new. But I never planned on no one like you. Got no use for moonlight or sappy poetry. Love at first sight for suckers. At least it used to be.
Quiet down, there's a show going on.
Oh, you are the most impossible boy.
Shh.
Ever.
No, I never planned on no one like you.
sirens kept me awake all night.
Sirens is like lullabies to me. Latter day whale, the better the headline. And the better the headline, the better I eat. And the better I eat,
the further away from you I sleep.
Morning, everybody. Sorry we're late. We had to help our mom with something.
Ah, they got a mutter! I was gonna get me one.
What'd you do with the one you had?
He traded her for a box of cigars.
They was Coronas!
We have a fada, too.
A mutter and a fada.
Ain't we the hoi polloi?
So how's it going today?
Ask me after they put up the headline.
Here it comes now.
New newsy price was 60 cents per hundred.
What'd you say?
Is that news?
It is to me.
Oh, they jacked up the price of the papes. 10 cents more a hundred.
I could eat 2 days on a dime.
I'll be sleeping on the street.
You already sleep on the street.
In a worse neighborhood.
Hey, what are y'all doing standing around for?
Get a load of this, Jack.
Like Pulitzer don't make enough already.
Papes for the newsies.
Relax. It's gotta be a gag.
Line up!
Good joke, Weasel. Really got the fellas going.
Yeah.
Take the 100, be on my way.
100 will cost you 60.
I ain't paying no 60.
Step aside for someone who will.
You bet. Me and the fellas will take a hike over to the Gino.
I'll save you the walk. They got their price, too.
Then we'll take our business to the sun.
Same story all around town. New day. New price.
Why the jack up?
For them kind of answers, you're going to have to ask further up the food chain. Now, are you buying or are you moving along?
Come in, fellas.
Oh, they can't just do that, can they?
Why not? It's their pay.
It's their world.
Ain't we got no rights?
Yeah. We got the right to stop. Come on, let's get our papes and hit the streets while we still can.
At them prices.
We got a choice?
Hold on. Ain't nobody paying no new nothing.
Well, you got an idea?
Keep your shirt on. Let me think it through.
Hey, what's your angle?
Stop crowding him! Let the man work it out! Hey, Jack? You still thinking?
Sure he is. Can't you smell smoke?
All right, here's the deal. If we don't sell papes, then no one sells papes. Nobody gets to that window till they put the price back where it belongs.
You mean like a strike?
You heard, Davey. We're on strike.
I did not say that.
We'll shut this place down like them workers shut down the trolley.
And the cops will bust our heads. Half them strikers is laid up with broke bones.
Cops ain't gonna care about a bunch of kids, right, Davey?
Leave me out of this. I'm just here trying to feed my family.
And the rest of us is on playtime? Just because we only make pennies, don't give no one the right to rub our noses in.
It doesn't matter. You can't strike. You're not a union.
What if I says we is?
There's a lot of stuff you gotta have in order to be a union. Like, membership.
What do you call these guys?
And officers.
I nominate Jack president.
How about a statement of purpose?
I must have left it in my other pants.
What is a statement of purpose?
A reason for forming the union.
What reason them trolley workers have?
I don't know. Wages, work hours, safety on the job.
Who don't need that? Bet if your father had a union, you wouldn't be out here selling papes right now, yeah?
Yeah.
So, our union is hereby formed to watch each other's backs. Union do we stand.
All right.
That's pretty good. Somebody write that down.
Well, I got a pencil.
Meet our Secretary of State. What's next?
If the membership wants to strike, you take a vote.
Then let's vote. What do you say, fellas? The choice is yours. Do we roll over and let Pulitzer pick our pockets? Or do we strike?
Strike!
You heard the voice of the membership. The newsies of Lower Manhattan are officially on strike. What's next?
Wouldn't a strike be more effective if someone in charge knew about it?
It would be a pleasure to tell Weasel myself.
Yeah? And who tells Pulitzer? Davey?
I do not. I guess you do, Mr. President!
Yes, yes. We do! And what do we tell him?
The newspaper owners need to
respect your rights as employees.
Pulitzer and Hearst gotta respect the rights of all working kids in this city.
They can't just change the rules whenever they feel like it.
That's right, we do the work so we get some set.
We've got a union!
Pulitzer and Hearst, they think we're nothing. Are we nothing?
No!
They need to understand we are not enslaved to them. We are free agents.
Pulitzer and Hearst, they think they got us. Do they got us?
No!
We're a union now. The Newsboy Union, and we mean business.
Even though we ain't got hats or badges, we're a union just by saying so. And the world will know.
What's to stop some of the kids coming along to sell our paints?
Oh, just let them try.
Hey, we cannot beat up on other kids. We're all in this together. Now, come on.
What's it gonna take to stop the wagons? Can we do it?
Yeah!
What's it gonna take to stop the scabbers? Are we ready?
Yeah!
We'll do what we gotta do until we break the will of mighty Bill and Joe. Delancey's come out swinging. Will we hear it?
No!
When you got 100 voices singing, who can hear a lousy whistle blow? And the world will know that this ain't no game. That we got a ton of rotten fruit and perfect things. So they gave their word, but it ain't worth beans. Now you're gonna see what stop the presses. And the torch is passed, and the war.
father for you, and one for you, and one for you, and you. Now, what's the big man with ordered seltzer?
Over here.
And that'll be 2 cents.
Oh, 2 cents for a glass of seltzer? Just give me water.
How did I ever see that coming?
Well, I'd say we launched our strike in the most auspicious manner.
What?
Auspicious?
What?
I don't know about that, but we sure scared the bejeebus out of Weasel!
Okay.
You see the Delanceys? They didn't know which way was up!
Yeah!
So what's next?
Now you spread the word. Let the rest of the city's newsies know about the strike.
You heard the man. Split up and spread the word.
I got Harlem.
I got Midtown.
I got the Bronx.
And I got the Bowery.
All right. Specs, you take Queens. Tommy Boy, East Side. Who wants Brooklyn? Oh. Oh, come on, Brooklyn. It's Bob Conlin's turf. Finch, you telling me you're scared of Brooklyn?
I ain't scared of no turf. But that Bob Conlin gets me a little jittery.
Me and Davey will take Brooklyn.
I don't want it!
Why is everyone so scared of Brooklyn?
Oh, what are you doing here?
Asking a question. Have you got an answer?
Brooklyn's the sixth largest city in the world. You got Brooklyn. You hit the mother load. You know, for someone who works for the New York Sun, you spend an awful lot of time around the world. So what's that about? You following me?
The only thing I'm following is a story. A ragtag gang of ragamuffins wants to take on the kingmakers of New York. Think you have a chance?
Shouldn't you be at the ballet?
Question too difficult? I'll rephrase. Will the richest and most powerful men in New York give the time of day to a gang of kids who haven't got a nickel to their name?
You don't gotta be insulting. I got a nickel.
So I guess you'd say you're a couple of Davids looking to take on Goliath?
Hey, we never said that.
You didn't have to. I did.
You know, I've seen a lot of papes in my day, and I ain't never noted no girl reporters writing hard news.
Wake up to the new century. The game's changing. How about an exclusive interview?
Ain't you beat entertainment?
This is entertaining. So far.
What's the last news story you wrote?
What's the last strike you organized?
You're out of your league, Kelly. Methinks the lady needs to be handled by a real man.
You think's wrong, Romeo.
How's she know my name?
I'd say we save any exclusive for a real reporter.
Oh, you see somebody else giving you the time of day? All right. So I'm just busting out of the social pages. But you give me the exclusive, let me run with the story, and I promise I'll get you the space.
Do you really think we could be in the papes?
Shut down a paper like The World, and you're gonna make the front page.
Jack.
You want a story? Be at the circulation gate tomorrow morning and you'll get one. And bring a camera with you. You're gonna want to get a fix of this.
Yeah!
Go! All of you, go play outside. I've got to set up for dinner. I've got paying customers what need the table.
Come on, we got newsies to visit.
You won't be showing us off when we get our mugs in the paint.
Yeah.
In a world where no one keeps it for.
Are you selling newspapers to work your way through art school?
Art school? Are you kidding me?
But you're an artist. You've got real talent. You should be inside the papers illustrating, not outside hawking it.
Maybe that ain't what I want.
So tell me what you want.
Can't you see it?
In my eyes?
Have you always been their leader?
I'm just a blowhard. Davey's the brains.
Modesty is not a quality I would have pinned on you.
You got a name?
Catherine. Plumber.
What's the matter? Ain't you sure?
It's my byline. The name I publish under. Tell me about tomorrow. What are you hoping for?
Well, I'd rather tell you what I'm hoping for tonight.
Mr. Kelly.
Today we stopped our newsies from selling papes, but the wagons still delivered papes all across the city. Tomorrow, we stop the wagons.
Are you scared?
Do I look scared? But ask me again in the morning.
Good answer. Good night, Mr. Kelly.
Where are you running? It ain't even supper time.
I'll see you in the morning. And off the record, good luck.
Hey, plumber, write it good. We both got a lot riding on you.
You heard the man. Write it good. Write it good or it's back to wheezing your way through the flower show. No pressure. Let's go. Newsies stop the world. A little hyperbole never hurt anyone. With all eyes fixed on the trolley strike, there's another battle brewing in the city. If I could just write about it. Come on, Catherine. Those boys are counting on you. Oh, those poor boys. Write what you know, so they say. All I know is I don't know what to write or the right way to write it. This is big, lady, don't screw it up. This is not some little vaudeville I'm reviewing. Poor little kids versus rich, greedy sourpusses. Oh, it's a cinch! It can practically write itself, and let's pray it does. Because as I may have mentioned, I have no clue what I'm doing. Am I insane? This is what I've been waiting for. Well, that plus the screaming of 10 angry editors. A girl? It's a girl. How the hell is that even legal? Look, just go and get her. Not only that, there's a story behind the story. Thousands of children exploited, invisible. Speak up, take a stand, and there's someone to write about it. That's how things get better. Give life's little guy some ink, and when it dries, just watch what happens. Those kids will live and breathe right on the page, and once they're center stage, you watch what happens. And who's there with her camera and her pen? As boys turn into men, they'll storm the gates and then just watch what happens when they do. A modern-day David is poised to take on the rich and powerful Goliath. With the swagger of one twice his age and nothing more than a few nuggets of the truth, Jack Kelly stands ready to face the behemoth Pulitzer. Now that's how you turn a boy into a legend. Picture a handsome, heroically charismatic, plain-spoken, know-nothing, skirt-chasing, cocky little son of a... Lie down with dogs and you wake up with a raise and a promotion. So he's a flirt, a complete egomaniac. The fact is he's also the face of the strike. What a face, face the fact, that's a face that could save us all from sinking in the ocean. Like someone said, power tends to corrupt an absolute power. Wait, wait, corrupts? Absolutely, that is genius. But give me some time, I'll be twice as good as that. 6 months from never. Just look around at the world we're inheriting and think of the one we'll create. Their mistake is they got old. That is not a mistake we'll be making. No, sir, we'll stay young forever. Give those kids and me the brand new century and watch what happens. It's David and Goliath, do or die. The fight is on and I can't watch what happens. But all I know is nothing happens if you just give in. It can't be any worse than how it's been. And it just so happens that we just might win. So whatever happens, let's begin.
Is anybody else coming?
Don't got a clue.
You seen Spot Conlon, right? What'd he say?
Yeah, we seen him.
Him and about 20 of his gang.
Yeah, and them Brooklyn boys is big.
Yeah, and Spot seemed very impressed, didn't he?
I'd say.
So they're with us?
Well, that depends on how you look at it. If you look and see Brooklyn, then sure, they're with us.
They wanted proof that we're not gonna fold at the first sign of trouble.
Are we?
We are not. There's us in Harlem.
Oh, not so fast, boss. Harlem wants to know what Brooklyn's gonna do.
Well, how about Queens?
Queens be right here backing us up.
There you go.
See?
As soon as they get the nod from Brooklyn.
I got the same fisheye in Midtown.
Hey, Oscar. Looks like we got some bum information about strike happening today. It's okay. Just go bash around and use a day's rest.
Are we doing the right thing?
Hey, sure we are.
Maybe we put this off a couple days.
No, we can't. Jack, you gotta tell him. If we back down now, they're never gonna listen to us again.
We can't back down now. No matter who does or doesn't show, whether we like it or not, now is the time we take a stand.
How's about we just don't show for work? That'll send a message.
They'll just replace us. They gotta see us standing our ground. Davey, you tell them.
Now is the time to seize the day. Stare down the odds and seize the day. Minute by minute, that's how you win it. We will find a way. But let us seize the day.
Hey, Jack, look what I made. Good, huh? Strike!
That's great! That's pitiful.
Don't be so quick to judge. Maybe Pulitzer will see it outside of his window and feel sorry for us.
Hey, Specs, any sign of reinforcements? Davey.
Courage cannot erase our fear. Courage is when we face our fear. Tell those with power, safe in their tower, we will not obey.
Behold the brave battalion that stands side by side, too few in number and too proud to hide, and say to the others who did not follow through, you're still our brothers and we will fight for you. Now is the time to seize the day. Stare down the odds and seize the day. Once we've begun, if we stand as one, someday we come somehow. And a prayer becomes a vow.
And the strike starts right there.
The birds are singing. It is a beautiful day to crack some heads.
Your work or no trespassing? What's your pleasure?
Step right up here and get your papers.
Jack, who are they?
Scabs, who do you think?
If they think they can just waltz in here and take our jobs,
we can handle it.
Let's talk them, boys.
Hey!
We cannot. If we don't stand together, then we don't stand a chance. Jack, say something to them.
Yeah, all right, I hear you. Look. I know someone put you up to this. Probably paid you a little extra money, too, yeah? Well, it ain't right. Pulitzer thinks we're gutter rats, with no respect for nothing, including each other. Is that who we are? Well, we stab each other in the back, and yeah, that's who we are. But if we stand together, we change the whole game, and it ain't even just about us. All across this city, boys and girls who ought to be outside playing, or going to school. Instead, they're slaving to support themselves and their folks. Ain't no crime to being poor. And not a one of us complains when the work we do is hard. All we ask is a square deal. So for every child in every factory, sweatshop, and slaughterhouse across this town, I beg you, throw down your papers. and join the strike.
Please?
I'm with you!
off to the refuge with you, little man. Take him away.
Crunchy?
Crunchy!
We finally got a headline. Newsies crushed his bull's attack. Crunchy's calling me. Dumb Crip's just too damn slow. Guys are fighting, bleeding, falling. Thanks to good old Captain Jack. Well, Captain Jack just wants to close his eyes and go! Let me go. Far away, somewhere they won't never find me, and tomorrow won't remind me of today. When the city's finally sleeping, and the moon looks old and gray, I get on a train that's bound for Santa Fe. And I'm gone! And I'm done! No more running, no more lying, no more fat old men denying me my pay. Just the moon so big and yellow, it turns night right into day. Dreams come true, yeah, they do, in Santa Fe. Where does it say? You gotta live and die here. Where does it say a guy can't catch a break? Why should you only take what you're given? Why should you spend your whole life living trapped where there ain't no future? Even at 17, breaking your back for someone else's sake. But the life don't seem to suit ya. How about a change of scene? Far from the lousy headlines and the deadlines in between. Santa Fe, my old friend. I can't spend my whole life dreaming, though I know that's all I seem inclined to do. I ain't getting any younger, and I wanna start brand new. I need space and fresh air. Let them laugh in my face. I don't care. Save my place. I'll be there. Be real is all I'm asking, not some painting in my head. 'Cause I'm dead if I can't count on you today. I got nothing if I ain't got Santa Fe.
Come on now, drink up. And don't say I don't ever give you nothing. Oh, and before you think that water is nothing, just ask a fish. In the desert.
Why do old people talk? To prove they still alive.
Good morning. Oh, would you get a load of these glum mugs? Could these really be the same boys who just made the front page of the New York Sun?
The front page of what? Let me see. Look it. Would you look it? That's me.
Front page 88.
But where's me? Where's me?
Wait till my old man gets a load of this. I won't be last in line for the top tonight.
You got us in the pape?
You got yourselves in the pape.
Newsy, stop the world. There's a headline even Elma could sell.
What else you got?
Mine's the only story that ran. Pulitzer declared a blackout on strike news, so even I'm shut down now. Hey, I heard they arrested Crutchy. Did they get Jack, too?
Well, the Delanceys are spreading the story that Jack took it on the lam first sight of the cops.
Jack don't run from no fight.
Well, take it down, shortstop. I'm just reporting the news.
For jumping Jack's sake, could you stow the seriosity long enough to drink in the moment? I'm famous.
What of it?
You stupid or what? You're famous. The world is your erster.
Your what?
Your erster. Your erster. Your fancy clam with a poil inside?
How much does being famous pay?
You don't need money when you're famous. They give you whatever you want, gratis.
Such as?
A pair of new shoes with matching laces.
A permanent box at the Sheephead races.
A Charmion rye with a sour pickle.
My personal puss on a wooden nickel. Look at me, I'm the king of New York. Staring right at ya, lousy with stature.
Knobbing with all the muckety mucks. I'm blowing my dough and going deluxe.
And dare I be, ain't I pretty? It's my city, I'm the king of New York.
Gold watch with a chain to twirl it. My very own dad and an indoor turlet.
Bobby Chappie, cause they cost a quarter.
A regular beat for the Star Reporter.
And Trey Punk, she's the king of New York.
Who the fuck?
Tomorrow they may wrap dishes in it, but I was a star for 100.
Dear Jack, greetings from the refuge. How are you? I'm okay. Guess I wasn't much help yesterday. Snyder soaked me real good with my crutch. Oh yeah, Jack, this is Crutchy, by the way. These here guards, they is rude. They say jump, boy, you jump or you're screwed. But the food ain't so badly so far, 'cause so far they ain't brung us no food. Ha, ha. I miss the rooftop. Sleeping right out in the open, in your penthouse in the sky. There's a cool breeze blowing even in July. Anyway, so guess what? There's a secret escape plan I got. Tie a sheet to the bed, toss the end out the window, climb down and take off like a shot. Maybe though, not tonight. I ain't slept and my legs still ain't right. Hey, but Pulitzer, he's going down. And in Jack, I was thinking we might just go, like you were saying. Where it's clean and green and pretty, with no buildings in your way. And you're riding Palominos every day. Once that train makes...
Shut up in there!
Damn this place. I'll be fine. Good as new. But there's one thing I need you to do. On the rooftop, he said, the family looks out for each other. So you tell all the fellas for me to protect one another. The end. Your friend. Your best friend. Your brother. Crutchy.
You in there, pipe down!
Here's everything I owe you for the first backdrop plus this one. And even a little something extra just to counter because I'm gonna miss you so.
Miss Meta.
Jack.
You're a gem.
Just tell me you're going somewhere and not running away.
Does it matter?
Well, when you go somewhere and it turns out not to be the right place, you can always go somewhere else. But if you're running away, no place is ever gonna be the right place.
How about letting a pal know you're alive?
Well, why don't I leave you with your friend?
Where did you go? We couldn't find you.
Ever think I didn't want to be found?
Hey, is that a real place? Oh, is that Santa Fe? Hey, did you see the paper? We are front page news above the fold. Oh, yes, my friend. Above the fold.
Good for you.
Everyone wants to meet the famous Jack Kelly.
Even Spot Common sent over a kid from Brooklyn just to say next time you can count on Brooklyn. How about that?
We got stomped into the ground.
Yeah, they got us this time. I'll give you that one. But with press like this, our fight is far from over.
Every newsie who could walk showed up this morning to sell papes like the strike never even happened.
And I was right there with them. If I don't sell papes, my folks don't eat.
Save your breath. I get it. It's hopeless.
But then I saw this look on Weasel's face, and he was actually nervous. And then I realized that this is not over. We got him worried, Jack. Really worried. And so I walked away. Lots of other kids did too, and that is what you call a beginning.
There he is, just like I said.
For crying out loud, what's a fella gotta do to get away from you people?
Oh, you can't escape us, pal. We're inevitable.
So what's the story? Can we leave the theater?
Pipe down. I didn't ask yet.
What's the holdup? I need to let my fella know we've got a date.
Your fella?
You heard me. I've been swatting fellas all morning. Fame is one intoxicating potion. And this fella here, Sully, quite the poisonality.
Story is, you wrote a great paper.
You look like hell.
Hey, Jack, where's that supposed to be?
It's Santa Fe.
I've got to tell you, Jack, this go west young man routine is getting tired. Even Horace Greeley moved back to New York.
Yes, he did. And then he died.
Ain't reporters supposed to be nonpartisan?
Ask a reporter. Pulitzer's had me blacklisted from every news desk in town.
Can we table the palaver and get back to business? Will Meta let us have the theater?
It's what I've been trying to tell you. We want to hold a rally here, citywide, where every newsie gets a say and a vote. And we do it after working hours so no one loses a day's pay. Smart?
Smart enough to get you committed to a padded room.
The guy who paints places he's never seen is calling us crazy?
You want to see a place I've seen? Take a look at this. Newsy Square. Thanks to my big mouth. Kids hurt. Others arrested.
Oh, lighten up. No one died.
Is that what you're aiming for? Go on and call me a coward. Call me a quitter. There ain't no way I'm putting them kids back in danger.
We're doing something that's never been done before. How could that not be dangerous?
Specs brought me a note from Crutchy at the refuge. I tried to see him, climbed up the fire escape, but they beat him so bad, he couldn't even come to the window. What if you don't make it? You willing to shoulder that for the tenth of a penny of a pace?
It's not about pennies, Jack. You said it yourself. If my father had had a union, we wouldn't be in the mess that we're in right now. This is a fight we have to win.
If I wanted a sermon, I'd go to church.
Tell me how quitting does Crutchy any good. Exactly. So here's how it goes once we win, and we will be winning, make no mistake.
We'll be what?
We're already winning.
Right.
And we'll tell them straight out, they let Crutchy go or they keep getting pounded.
Dave, what the hell? Did they bust up your brains or something? As I recall, Dave, we all got our asses kicked. They won.
Won the battle.
Come on.
Jackie, think about it. We got them surrounded.
Here's what I think. Joe's a jerk. He's a rattlesnake.
You're right. And you know why a snake starts to rattle?
No, why?
Because he's scared. Go and look it up, the poor guy's head is spinning. Why did he send for the goons? An entire army dozens of goons, put the cops and...
You know, you may be right.
Thank you, God.
If he wasn't afraid...
Exactly.
He knows we're winning. Get those kids to see we're circling victory and watch what happens. We're doing something no one's even tried, and yes, we're terrified, but watch what happens.
You can't undo the past.
Don't just move on
and stay on track. Cause Humpty Dumpty is about to crack.
We've got faith.
We've got the plan.
And we've got Jack.
So just watch what happens. We're back.
I've read your editorials, Mr. Pulitzer. How can you express such sympathy for the trolley workers and have none at all for the newsies?
Because the trolley workers are striking for a fair contract. The newsies are striking against me.
I would save you this embarrassment if I could, but the burlesque house is private property.
Oh, he can't order a raid without a legal cause.
Mr. Mayor, would the fact that this rally is organized by an escaped convict be enough to shut it down?
An escaped convict?
A fugitive from one of your own institutions. A convicted thief at large wreaking mischief on our law-abiding community. Mr. Snyder, which one is he?
That's him, Jack Kelly.
How do you know this boy?
The story is not a pleasant one. He was first sentenced to my refuge for vagrancy and loitering, but his blatant disregard for authority has made him a frequent visitor.
You called him a thief, an escaped convict?
After his release, I caught him myself, red-handed, trafficking stolen food and clothing. He was sentenced to 6 months, but the willful ruffian escaped.
So, you'd be doing the city a service, removing this criminal from our streets.
If that's the case, we can take him in quietly. We can...
What good would quiet do me? I want a public example made of him.
Mr. Pulitzer, the boy, Jack Kelly, is here.
Here?
Just outside. He's asked to see you.
Ask, and ye shall be received. Mr. Snyder, if you please. Sit.
Mr. Jack Kelly.
Good morning, boys.
And which Jack Kelly is this? The charismatic union organizer or the petty thief and escaped convict?
Which one gives us more in common?
Impudence is in bad taste when crawling for mercy.
Crawling? That's a laugh. I just dropped by with an invite. Seems a few hundred you employees have rallied outside to discuss recent disagreements. I thought it only fair to let you state your case straight to the fellas. So what do you say, Joe? When I should put your name on the bill?
You are as shameless and disrespectful a creature as I was told. Do you know what I was doing when I was your age, boy? I was fighting in a war.
How'd that work out for you?
It taught me a lesson that shaped my life. You don't win a war on the battlefield. It's the headline that crowns the victor.
I'll keep that in mind when New York wakes up to front page photos of our rally.
Oh, rally till the cows come home. Not a paper in town will print a word. And if it's not in the paper, it never happened.
You may run this town, but there are those of us who can't be bullied. Even some reporters.
Such as that young woman who made you yesterday's news? Talented girl. And beautiful, too, don't you think?
I'll tell her you said so.
No. No need. She can hear for herself. Can't you, darling? Now, I trust you know my daughter, Catherine. Yes. My daughter. I offered Catherine a life of wealth and leisure. Instead, she chose to pursue a career. But you're done with all that now, aren't you, sweetheart?
Jack, I...
No. Don't trouble the boy with your problems, dearest. Mr. Kelly has a plate full of his own. Wouldn't you say so, Mr. Snyder?
Whoa, Jack.
Does anyone else feel a noose tightening? Allow me to offer an alternate scenario. You attend the rally, speak out against this hopeless strike, and I'll see your criminal record expunged. Fill your pockets with enough cash to transport you in a first-class train compartment from New York to New Mexico and beyond. You did say he wanted to travel west, didn't you?
There ain't a person in this room who don't know you stink!
And if they know me, they know I don't care. Mark my words, boy. Defy me, and I'll see you and all your friends locked up in the refuge. Now, you may be Mr. Tough Guy, but it's not right to condemn that little crippled boy to conditions like that. And what about your pal, Davy, and his baby sister, ripped from a loving family and tossed to the rats? Will they ever be able to thank you enough? Time's running out, kid. So what do you say? Cowboy or convict? I win either way. Your abject surrender was always the bottom line. Gentlemen, escort our guest to the cellar so he might reflect in solitude. Too bad you've no job, Jack, but you did resign. Too bad you've no family, but you can't have mine. Be glad you're alive, boy. I say that's the bottom line.
Like the Pied Piper, you knew what to play.
Till those kids all believed you were right.
Lucky for them, all but one got away.
They may not be so lucky tonight.
We can give a full discretion out of hand if we see fit. So, behave. Just in case, I've been polishing my favorite brass knuckles.
You can sleep right here beside so pretty breast.
Now that's fur.
Friendliest place on earth. Pay us a visit, see what we miss. And when you do,
we'll kick your hat.
Here tonight. Tonight, you're all making history! Yeah! Tonight we declare that we are just as much as part of the newspaper as any reporter or editor. They are done treating us like kids. We will be seen as equals! Come on!
Yeah! You want to be talked to like an adult? Start acting like one. Don't just run your mouth off. Make some sense.
And here's Jack.
Jack! All right! Pulitzer raised the price of papes without so much as a word to us, so that was a lousy thing to do. So we got mad and let them know that we ain't gonna be pushed around. So we go on strike. Then what happens? Pulitzer lowers the price of papes, so we goes back to working. Then in a few weeks, he hikes the price back up again, and don't think he won't. So what do we do then? And what do we do when he decides to raise the price again after that? Look, we gotta be realistic. We don't work, we don't get paid. How many days can you go without making money? However long, believe me, Pulitzer can go longer. I've spoken to Mr. Pulitzer, and he's given his word. If we disband the union, he will not raise the price again. For 2 years, he'll even put it in writing. I say we take the deal. Go back to work and know that the price is good. All you have to do is vote no on the strike. Vote no.
That was some speech you made.
How'd you get here?
Specs showed me.
You say you could go through my stuff, too?
I saw them rolled up, sticking out of there. I didn't know what they were. These drawings? These are drawings of the refuge, aren't they? Is this really what it's like in there? 3 boys to a bed, rats everywhere, and vermin?
A little different from where you grew up?
Snyder told my father you were arrested for stealing food and clothing. This is why, isn't it? You stole to feed those boys. I don't understand. If you were so willing to go to jail for them, why turn your back on them now?
I don't think you're anyone to talk about turning on folks.
I never turned on you or anyone else.
No, you just double-crossed us to your father. Your father!
My father has eyes on every corner of this city. He doesn't need me spying for him. And I didn't lie. I just didn't tell you everything.
If you weren't a girl, you'd be trying to talk with a fist in your mouth.
I told you that I worked for the Sun, and I did. I told you my professional name was Plumber, and it is. You didn't ask my real one.
I wouldn't think I had to unless I knew I was dealing with a backstabber.
And if I was a boy, you'd be looking at me through one swollen eye.
Well, don't let that stop you. Give me your best shot.
I need to know you didn't cave for the money.
I told the truth. You win a fight when the other fella's down on the ground eating paper. You heard your father. No matter how many days we strike, he ain't giving up. I don't know what else we can do.
Ah, but I do.
Oh, come on.
Really, Jack, really? Only you can have a good idea? Or is it because I'm a girl?
I ain't saying
now
anything.
Now would be a good time to shut up. Being a boss doesn't mean you have all the right answers. Just the brains to recognize the right one when you hear it.
I'm listening.
Good for you. The strike was your idea. The rally was Davies, and now my plan will take us to the finish line. Deal with it.
The Children's Crusade.
For the sake of all the kids in every sweatshop, factory, and slaughterhouse, I beg you, join us. With those words, the strike stopped being just about the newsies. You challenged our whole generation to stand up and demand a place at the table.
The Children's Crusade?
Oh, think, Jack, think! If we publish this, my words with one of your drawings, and if every worker under 21 read it and stayed home from work, or better yet, came to Newsy Square, a general citywide strike! Even my father couldn't ignore that.
Only one problem, we ain't got no way to print it.
Come on, there's got to be one printing press he doesn't control.
Oh, no.
What?
I know where there's a printing press that no one would ever think we'd use.
Well, then why are we still standing here? Let's go!
Wait, stop! What's this about for you? I don't mean the Children's Crusade. What's this about? I mean, am I kidding myself, or is there something...
Of course there is.
Don't say it like it happens every day.
Oh, Jack.
I'm not an idiot. I know girls like you don't wind up with guys like me, and I don't want you promising nothing you gotta take back later. But standing here tonight looking at you, I'm afraid tomorrow's gonna come and change everything. If there was some way I could just grab hold of something to make time stop, so as I could keep looking at you.
You snuck up on me, Jack Kelly. And I didn't even see it coming.
For sure?
For sure. Till the moment I found you, I thought I knew what love was. But now I'm learning what is true, that love will do what it does. The past finds ways to sting you, and then one day decides to bring you something to believe in for even a night. One night may be forever, but that's alright, that's alright. And if I'm gone tomorrow, what was ours still will be. I have something to believe in. Now that I know you believed in me.
We were never meant to meet, and then we meet. Who knows why? One more stranger on the street, just someone sweet passing by. An angel come to save me, who didn't even know. She gave me something to believe in for even a day. One day, maybe forever, but that's okay, that's okay. And if I'm gone tomorrow, what was ours still will be. I have something to believe in, now that I know you believed in me. You know what I believe in. Look into my eyes and see. Things were different.
If you weren't going to Santa Fe.
And if you weren't an heiress. And if your father wasn't after my head.
You're not really scared of my father.
No. But I am pretty scared of you.
Don't be.
And if I'm gone tomorrow,
what was ours still will be. I have something to believe in. Now that I know you believe.
Building. Someone been picking Daddy's pockets?
The janitor's been working here since he was 8 and hasn't had a raise in over 20 years. He's with us 100%.
Wow. You bring enough fellows to keep us covered?
We could hold a hoe down in here and no one would be the wiser.
Good job.
Hey, it's good to have you back.
Shut up.
Here she is, boys. Just think. While my father snores blissfully in his bed, we'll be using his very own press to bury him down!
Remind me to stay on your good side.
Is this what they print the papes on?
I can see why they tossed this old girl down to the cellar, but I think she will do the job.
Jack, this is Darcy. He knows just about everything you need to know about printing.
You work for the papes?
My father owns the Trib.
And this is Bill. He'll be typesetting the article for us.
Bill, huh? I suppose you're the son of William Randolph Hearst.
And proud to be a part of your revolution.
Ain't that something else?
In the words of the little one, can we table the palaver and get down to business?
A little grease and she'll be as good as gold.
All right. Here's how it'll work. Race, as we print the papes, you let the fellas in, and I'll spread them to every working kid in New York. After that,
it's up to them.
There's change coming once and for all. You makes the front page, and man, you is major news. Tomorrow they'll see what we are, and sure as a star, we ain't come this far to lose.
Here they come!
This is the story we needed to write. Let's make it out of sight, but no more. In a few hours, by dawn's early light, we'll be ready to fight us a war. This time we're in it to stay. Talk about seizing the day.
Write it in ink or in blood, it's the same either way. They're gonna damn well pay.
Steel Man Pulitzer snug in his bed. He don't care if we're dead or alive. Bricks and pillows are under his head while he's begging for bread to survive. Show you can stop counting sheep. We're gonna sing yet asleep. Then while you snooze, we'll be light and infused with the promise we take in the keep.
If they're all, if they don't mind their manners, we'll bleed
up. Once and for all, we will carry no banners that don't stop.
Freedom, finally we break in the stakes. This time whatever it takes. This time the union awaits. Once and for all.
In the words of union leader Jack Kelly, we will work with you. We will even work for you, but we will be paid and treated as valuable members of your organizations. Riveting stuff, huh?
Get going. You got a very important man to see.
Keep your fingers crossed.
Hey, for us to...
This is for kids shining shoes on the street with no shoes on their feet every day. This is for guys sweating blood in the shop while their bosses and cops look away. Kids standing tall, glaring and raring the brawl. Armies of guys who are sick of the life, getting ready to rise to the call.
entire city is shut down. No one is working anywhere, and everyone is blaming you.
They're all calling. The mayors, the publishers, the manufacturers, and such language.
You can't just barge in and...
How are we doing this afternoon, gents?
You're behind this? We had a deal.
And it came with a money-back guarantee. Thanks for the lesson on the power of the press.
Have you read this, boss? These kids put out a pretty good paper. Very convincing.
No doubt written by my daughter.
I'd sign it before someone else snatches her up.
I demand to know who defied my ban on printing strike material.
We're your loyal employees. We'd never take our business elsewhere.
It's the old printing press in the cellar.
I made you the offer of a lifetime. Anyone who does not act in his own self-interest is a fool.
Then what's that make you? This all started because you wanted to sell more papes. But now, your circulation is down 70%. Why didn't you just come talk to us?
Guys like Joe don't talk to nothings like us. But a very wise reporter told me a real boss don't need the answers. Just the smarts to snatch the right one when he hears it.
Now is the time to seize the day. Stare down the odds and seize the day. Minute by minute, that's how you win it. We will find a way.
Oh, look out there, Mr. Pulitzer. In case you ain't figured it out, we got you surrounded.
New York is closed for business. Paralyzed. You can't get a paper or a shoe shine. You can't send a message, get an elevator ride, or cross the Brooklyn Bridge. You can't even get out of your own building. So what's your next move?
Mr. Pulitzer, the mayor's here, plus your daughter, and... Oh, you're not gonna believe this.
Good morning, Mr. Pulitzer. I believe you know the governor.
Governor Roosevelt.
Joseph, 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 what have you done now?
I'm certain when you hear my explanation...
Thanks to Ms. Metalark for bringing your daughter to my office, I already have a thorough grasp of the situation. Graphic illustrations included. Bully is an expression I usually employ to show approval, but in your case, I simply mean bully. And, is this the boy of whom you spoke? How are you, son? I'm told we once shared a carriage ride.
Pleasure's mine, Mr. Governor.
Well, Joe, don't just stand there letting those children sing endlessly. Give him the good news.
What good news?
That you've come to your senses and rolled back prices. That is, unless, of course, you'd like to invite a full state senate investigation in your employment practices.
You wouldn't.
After the pressure you wielded to keep me from office, I'd do it with a smile. Come along, Joe. The only thing worse than a hard heart is a soft head. Think of the happiness you'd bring those children. He doesn't do happiness, does he?
Mr. Keller, if I may speak with you alone.
Keep your eyes on the stars, your feet on the ground. You can do this.
I can't put the price back down where it was. I'm sorry I can't. There are other considerations.
I get it. You gotta save face in front of all these other folks. I'm young, I ain't stupid.
Thank you for understanding.
But I got constituents with a legitimate gripe.
What if I were to reduce the raise by half? Get the others to do the same? Well, it's a compromise we can all live with.
But you eat our losses. From now on, every paper we can't sell, you buy back full price.
That's never been on the table. What's to stop Newsies from taking hundreds of papers they can't sell? My costs will explode.
No Newsies is gonna break his back hauling around papers he can't sell. But if he could take a few extra with no risk, he might sell them in your circulation and begin to grow. It's a compromise we can all live with.
That's not a bad head you have on your shoulders.
Deal?
That's disgusting.
That's just the price of doing business.
And the world will know we can keep in store. Even they get us our rights, or we get their award. We've been down too long, and we pay our dues. And the things we do today will be tomorrow.
My own personal pal, Governor Theodore Roosevelt.
Each generation must, at the height of its power, step aside and invite the young to share the day. You have laid claim to our world, and I believe the future in your hands will be bright and prosperous. And your drawings, Jack, have brought another matter to bear. Officer, if you please.
Look at Jack and Clay!
You missed me?
Yeah.
And look at what I got you. A gift straight from the refuge. Bring him in, officer.
It's Night of the Spider!
Jack, with those drawings, you make an eloquent argument for shutting down the refuge. Be assured that Mr. Snyder's abuses will go fully investigated. Officer, take him away.
Please. Your Highness, may I do the honors?
You gotta be joking.
And you'll be laughing all the way to the pin, little man. So long, sucker!
Thank you, Governor.
I can't help thinking, if one of your drawings convinced the governor to close the refuge, what might a daily political cartoon do to expose the dealings in our own government back rooms? What do you say, Teddy? Care to have this young man's artistry shine a lantern behind your closed doors?
Don't sweat it, Gov. With the strike settled, I ought to be hitting the road.
Don't you ever get tired of singing the same old tune? What's Santa Fe got that New York ain't? Sandstorms?
Better yet, what's New York got that Santa Fe ain't?
New York's got us. And we're family.
Didn't I hear something about the strike being settled?
Papes for the Newsies! Why not? These papes ain't gonna sell themselves!
Come along, Governor, and show me that back seat I keep hearing so much about.
Don't just stand there. You've got a union to run. Besides, didn't someone just offer you a pretty exciting job?
Yeah, right. Me? Work for your father?
You already work for my father.
Oh, yeah.
And you've got one more ace up your sleeve.
Yeah? What's that?
Me? Wherever you go, I'm right there by your side.
For sure?
For sure.
Don't take much to be a dreamer. All you do is close your eyes. But some made-up world is all you ever see. Now my eyes, they finally open. And my dreams, they average size, but they don't much matter if you ain't with me.
Hey!
Hi!
Okay, Kelly, come on. Are you in or are you out? Come on, Jack. I know you got it.
Oh, yeah. I got a nickel.